What is the best way to remove freckles when Fraxel failed? I am trying to remove the brown spots all over my pale face. I have had Fraxel, I use vitamin C, sunscreen, retinol, and hydroquinone. Fraxel caused overall improvement, but there is still a great deal left behind, and many of those removed started to return a few months later. I am continuing to work with my dermatologist, whom I really like, but all dermatologists have different lasers, and maybe they don't have what I need. Is there a laser I should be looking for? Suggestions appreciated.
Thank you for your question. You submitted your question without a photo. You describe in the details of your question that you want to remove freckles and brown spots all over your skin, which is, as you describe, pale, and that you are currently on vitamin C, retinol, and hydroquinone, as well as sunblock, and further, you have had a Fraxel treatment done by your dermatologist, and which appeared to have some benefit initially, but many of the pigmented areas appear to have returned. And you're asking about whether or not there are other laser options for these brown spots. Well, again, in the absence of photos, but I think from your description that I can conclude is what's likely the issue, I can give you some guidance as to how I treat my patients in my practice. A little bit of background, I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic and reconstructive surgeon. I've been in practice in Manhattan and Long Island for over 20 years. Helping people with their skin is a big part of my practice. In our practice, we do a lot of things in addition to the surgeries that involve skin products as well as various different ways to help the skin with lasers and light devices, as well as microneedling, PRP, and other things. So I would say that first you begin any strategy with a diagnosis, and it seems that your dermatologist is clearly on the right track, that what you are probably dealing with mostly is something called solar dyschromias. And these are brown spots that are the result of the exposure to the sun and your body's response to that exposure. And these spots can be round and irregular and have, and certainly I can see from your description that you did have a response mostly with the Fraxel, because the Fraxel laser, whether it was an erbium or CO2, essentially took off the top layers of skin. And if some of that pigment happened to be at that level, well, then it looked better until the pigment came back. Further, there is another part of the equation which you didn't mention and may not be the situation with you, but I would simply have you discuss this with your dermatologist, is how much of this pigmentation may be due to something called melasma. Melasma, which is pigmentation that is hormonally induced, has a different pattern compared to sun exposure or solar dyschromias, and sometimes it can be a little difficult to differentiate, and this can be, of course, overlap, where pigmentation and melasma can affect the upper lip, the cheek, the chin, and the forehead area in what's described as a geographic pattern, and the dyschromias can be more of like spots. You may be dealing with some residual effects, residual melasma, which is much more difficult to treat. In the end, the strategy is already there from the pharmaceutical standpoint or the skincare standpoint, where sunblock is critical, as well as other ways to help turn over your skin and get some of this epidermal pigmentation to be reduced. As far as the other laser options for the skin, you can think of intense pulse light or IPL. You can also think of something that we use in our practice a lot, which is a Q-switch laser. And a Q-switch laser can be customized to do something like laser toning, which is basically breaking up pigmentation kind of in more of an even way at a certain energy level, or directly treating the brown discolorations also with a Q-switch laser, but with a different wavelength. And so we can always customize this type of treatment, and as is with often the case with a lot of the dermatologic procedures we do, there's a certain procedures that we do for maintenance, and there are certain procedures that we do just to get rid of specific spots. But I find that the Q-switch laser has been very useful in my practice to help people with these very discrete brown discolorations, and they basically have a day or so of some redness, and then within a few days they see an improvement. So I think that it's worthwhile having this discussion with your dermatologist. I would be surprised if the dermatologist is using a lot of lasers in their practice that they wouldn't have a Q-switch laser. Essentially, when it comes to skin, I think most doctors who are doing treatments with any consistency are essentially obliged to have a certain set of lasers and light-based devices in order to really treat the common concerns, and of course with the most up-to-date devices that will provide the most optimal results with the minimal downtime. So that's something that I think is worth having that discussion with your doctor about, and I would be surprised if they didn't already have some of the devices that I described. So discuss this with your doctor, and if they don't have Q-switch laser or a pulse light device, then you may want to consider these options in conjunction with the skincare regimen that you're currently under. But I think, again, it's a discussion that you should have with your dermatologist, who I think is probably on the right track and maybe wants you to do the more Fraxels because of they have the perspective of knowing your skin and having a treatment strategy in mind. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck. Thank you for your question.